Hello everyone, welcome to an inspiration piece episode of Art Whisperer 88. Today's inspiration piece is by Serge Poliakoff, a Russian-born French modernist painter, and he started making abstract works in 1942. And he showed them for the first time in 1945. Now, Mr. Poliakoff has influenced me greatly. I love his geometric compositions and his beautiful treatment of colors. And he does these very subtle, sensitive layers upon layers of these rich jewel tones, which have influenced my aesthetic for many years. So today I am going to do a medium format, and I'm going to use Lucas cadmium red, some alizarin crimson, and some cadmium red light as a background. So stick around, I'll be right back. Okay everyone, here's the fun part. I'm going to start with a tiny bit of raw sienna. Then some cadmium red. And some alizarin crimson. Takes a little getting used to working on a smaller plate. You need to use less paint. So what I'm doing is spreading the paint in a very painterly fashion. So I have these zones of color. Okay. Let's see how this works out. Now, this is my watercolor paper from Blick. This is a 15x22 sheet of paper, and it has been meticulously registered, so I get 1.5 inches on the left, 1.5 inches border on the right, 3.5, from the top and 4 from the bottom. And with the help of these wooden bars, every time I put my paper down, it will always fall in the same place. Okay. Very cool background. So that's just for starters. Yeah, that's better. So I'm going to keep applying paint to the plate without cleaning it. So you could say it's kind of like doing a series. This time I will add a little bit of black. Like this. It's almost like a glaze. That's because the paints I'm using are semi-transparent. They have quite a bit of extenders in them, and that creates this very beautiful kind of glazing technique. Okay, on to the next one. Be using more of the cadmium red. Sienna. Now I just have to be careful not to do too much. So I'm going to start with the raw sienna. Check this out. Let me see if I can capture this with, I have some copper here. And again, a little bit of black. Now, usually I like to do my marks with a stick. I'm going to refrain from doing that because I want to show you how to create these painterly effects just by mixing the paint on the plate. Okay. Now, since I'm trying to capture the ghost print or the leftover paint, I will leave this a little bit longer, like for 5 minutes, and see what the effect is. Okay, it's been about 5 minutes. Let's see what we have here. I think it's a very good transfer. Pretty cool. Let's make a great background for collage. Okay, I think I'm going to stop now. I have 4 backgrounds and I will air dry all of them and proceed to the next step. Okay, I'm back. I think the desk fan has done a good job. Let me show you the dried result. So here's the first piece. The one with a little black. This one has more of the cadmium red light. And this one has the copper background. So I'm going to work on these with collage. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, everyone, here is the next segment of this video. Well, first of all, let me show you the image that I want to work on. This is the first piece with the tissue paper collage. And I want to put another layer of stencils on top. And I want to use this alizarin crimson, maybe a little copper, just to make this a little more complex. So I have arranged my reusable stencils. So I will go ahead and apply some of the darker red. Now, since the paint application is a little heavy, I may have put too much paint. I'm not going to press too hard on the paper. Pretty cool. Check this out. See if I can capture this ghost print. Here's the other collage. Cool. I'm going to try something. This may work, this may not work, I'm not sure. This time I will put a layer of raw sienna. Now there's a little bit of buckling on this paper, but I think when it dries it should straighten out. That's a pretty complex image. Going to overlap that on this. So I will air dry all four of these and then recap. Okay, here is a recap of all four pieces. And here's a close-up. you can see, the action of the brayer has created all these intricate lacy textures. Now, just for reference, I will put this to one side and compare it to the inspiration piece. Now on to the next one. The third one, which I think is very complex. Here's the last one. I hope you liked this video. I had a lot of fun with this experimental journey in reimagining the work of Serge Poliakoff in my own humble way. And I want to take this opportunity to thank all you viewers who have supported me, for all you subscribers, and thank you so much for watching. I hope to see you next time.